Hello friends, myself Professor Lal Patel from Indian Institute of Engineering and Technology, Automobile Engineering Department. Welcome to the lecture series of subject Vehicle Dynamics, in which we are continuing our chapter that is about rollover. So in previous lecture we have learned about rollover phenomena, like what do we mean by rollover, how that rollover is going to affect my overall vehicle while in driving condition or in different maneuvers like cornering, accelerating, braking each container. So we have done or we have basic idea about rollovers. So in today's lecture we will talk about the first topic, that is quasi-static rollover of suspended vehicle, in which suspension effect are going to be considered in which topic. And the second is about the third type of rollover, that is called transient rollover. So let us begin with the quasi-static rollover of a suspended vehicle. First let us remind you about the rollover. Like if the vehicle is moving in a highway or normal road condition, what will happen? Due to that mechanical damage of road or due to that mechanical failure of the vehicle is about to roll greater than 90 degree on top roof or by the side of the car. So that is called my rollover maneuvers. So we have seen many maneuvers like accelerating, braking, cornering, turning, and last one is that rollover. So rollover is basic crash type maneuvers that we have seen or we have to check. So ultimately this rollover effect can be done with the help of suspension arrangement. How that suspension are going to work and how that tire stiffness and grip is going to react with that ultimately in rollover. So we can say that about lateral forces that is perpendicular to that tire or cornering, in which we can see that there are so many chances by changing suspension diameter or suspension geometry, and that are going to affect my crash, or we can say the rollover effect. So in previous lecture we have studied about the quasi-static rollover of a rigid vehicle, in which we have neglected all the suspension effect as well as tire smoothness or tire tread smoothness. So from that we have found that due to that lateral acceleration we will find certain rollover threshold, so that we have to eliminate. But in actual practice we need suspensions to overcome these rollover conditions. So let us begin with the new topic, that is quasi-static rollover of a suspended vehicle. As we have seen that we are neglecting tire as well as suspension flexibility, and that overestimates the rollover threshold. So we can say that by eliminating that, the rollover threshold must be there. So in today's condition, in a suspended vehicle's condition, we will talk about the lateral force that transfers the unloads the inside wheels of the vehicle and increase the chances of load on the outside wheels. So we can say that the load in inner wheels are going to increase compared with the outside wheels. Moving further, the body works with a lateral shift of the center of gravity towards outside run. As we have seen that if the cornering is going to happen, what will happen? Our center of gravity is going to shift from inwards wheels to the outside wheels, or we can say to the outside turn also. So we can say that the offset of the center of gravity that reduce the moment arm on which the gravity force act to resist the rollover. So we can say that the force applied, we can say the lateral force that are going to be generated, that is going to resist the rollover. So for that we have a diagram in which we have to see how much forces or different forces are going to happen at which angle. So here you can see that the theta angle is there, FYI, FYO is there, even FZI, that is internal force on wheels for inner wheels, and also the another amount of force that is for outward wheels is there. H is the height, HY is for the roll center height. So that is one diagram regarding roll center phenomena. So the overall body, that is overall represented by the mass MS, that is connected to the axle at an imaginary point known as roll center. We have discussed about the roll center, like how roll center is going to be calculated. So overall mass is MS, and that is connected to the axle at imaginary point M at roll center. Now, we have known that the role center is a pivot around which body role occurs at which lateral forces are transferred from axle to the sprung mass. So we can say that the overall lateral forces generated at turning that are going to be transferred from axle to that sprung mass. That is an imaginary point at which body is going to roll. So now let us see the calculation part in which we can say that we are taking moments about at point where the right wheel contacts the ground. You can see that the right point, right wheel is going to touch the ground, and assuming that left wheel has gone zero load condition. So for that we have found such equation, like we are taking moment at outward base, and imagine that the inner wheels are going to have zero force at that inner wheel. So we will find such equation at which you can see that different nomenclatures like H, HR, T, you can see that from figure also. So from this equation we have to check our rollover phenomena. So let us continue that. Now imagine about the roll angle that the sprung mass phi is the roll rate of R phi times the lateral acceleration AY. So here you can say that the sprung mass phi that is equal to the roll rate R phi times at the lateral acceleration AY. We have seen in this in previous theory also. So define the roll rate. Like roll rate is the rate of change of roll angle with lateral acceleration expressed in units of radians per g. So that is about my roll rate. Moving further, now from that equation we have to change, or we have to assume certain data, like substituting to eliminate the roll angle, like we are taking phi is equal to 0 and solving that lateral acceleration. Now from that I will find this equation. So what we have done, we have eliminated that roll angle. Now let us simplify that equation mathematically. Like at first point you have seen that formula at which ms into ay into h is equal to ms into g in whole bracket t by 2 minus phi into h minus hr is equal to 0. So from that we have to consider about ay by g condition, in which we can see that ay into g we are taking to left side. The another simplification of that formula is going to happen. So ultimately my last equation says that ay by g is equal to t by 2h into 1 divided by 1 plus g into r phi into 1 minus hr by h. So that is my final formula, considering that the suspension effect or tire effect are going to consider in our theory, in which we can say that the cosystatic theory for suspension system at which we will find about the roll over. So that is all about this chapter rollover, in which you can see that there are several few theories, like rollover phenomena is there, cosystatic condition for suspended vehicle as well as rigid vehicle. The third and the final one, that is my transient rollover. So in which transient rollover we have till we have seen only one considered, that we have steady turn. We have considered steady turn. But what happens if the lateral acceleration are changing with respect to the time? So for that condition we have to consider that transient rollover condition, or we have to do analysis in a different way. So for that transient rollover is there, so in which the analysis have been cosystatic and model rollover only when the vehicle is in steady turn. So we have considered only steady turn, but when the lateral acceleration is changing as more slowly than the vehicle responds in roll, so for that condition transient rollover is there. So to examine the vehicle response, we rapidly changing lateral acceleration condition. So that is only going to happen with the help of a transient model if necessary. Now what do you mean by transient model? So that is the model that represents the view of vehicle with rolling condition with various time. So if I'm going to change my time, how the rolling is going to affect? So for that we need to see about the transient model. The last point, that is say that our simple roll model with combining motion in the U and roll planes have been developed to examine the role response associated with specific manual condition. So these are the points that we have to see for transient rollover condition. So that is all about this chapter that is called rollover. So these basic theories we have to keep in our mind, like rollover, rollover types, that quasi-static for suspended system, quasi-static analysis for rigid system, and transient rollover. So that is all about today's lecture. Thank you.